Thompson, your host. And today we have with us Otis Stroud. He's a program director for Right Moves for Youth. Thank you for joining us today, Otis.
Thanks for having me, Cynthia.
Before we start talking about Right Moves for Youth, let's talk about you a little bit. Tell me a little bit about your background.
Well, to start with me, I'm Otis Stroud II, currently program director at Right Moves for Youth. I'm a product of the Charlotte-Mecklenburg school system, and I'm a Charlotte native as well. Born and raised in Shannon Park community off of the plaza. I attended Broadwood Elementary, Cochran Middle School, and graduated from East Mecklenburg High School. Fortunately, at East Mecklenburg High School, I was able to join the Right Moves for Youth program as a high schooler and earned a scholarship and took that scholarship and went to UNC Chapel Hill where I earned my degree in business. And throughout the whole process of being in college, I always came back and volunteered. And I came back to Charlotte, and in between interviewing, I just found out that it was a position as program director, and I thought about it, and I realized that this is the best thing for me to be doing right now.
Yes, because you've gone through it throughout your whole education, and now you're program director. That is good.
Yes.
So what exactly is Right Moves for Youth?
Well, Right Moves for Youth is a dropout prevention organization that focuses on students in CMS from grades 4 to 12. We provide them with the tools such as motivation and resources to help them improve their attendance, their behavior, their social skills, and help them prepare themselves for the next step in life.
So you match the youth up with a mentor? Do they all have just one, or is it a group of people?
Well, the unique thing about it is we use a group format.
Okay.
And the way that it works, we have a group of students at a school site, and we have a number of volunteers that help teach a curriculum that we have to help the students improve in those areas.
Since you've been with Right Moves for Youth for so long, can you tell me how it started?
Well, Right Moves for Youth was founded in 1989 by Officer Dave Shepagrill, now Sergeant Shepagrill. He still works with CMPD. He started at Marie G. Davis Middle School, which is middle school now, and he saw the need for a program for young men and for young ladies as well to come together and use the peer pressure in a positive way to help them to start get a better perspective of law enforcement, a better perspective of authority, and to try to change those things around.
And so you told us earlier that you start with what grade again?
Fourth graders.
Fourth graders up until seniors in high school. And about how many kids participate in Right Moves for Youth?
Well, last year we had over 2,000 kids registered with Right Moves for Youth.
2,000?
Yes.
And you did different things with them?
Absolutely. We tailor our program to work with the elementary, the middle, and the high schools.
And who are the kids that you mostly target or the ones that you really want in your program?
Well, we have our program open to any student who would love to join the program because there's a lot of good things we do. But when you look at those areas that need the extra attention, it falls into the attendance, the behavior, the social skills, and whatnot. And fortunately, we've been able to partner with CMS, and we use part of their technology to extract information about these students regarding their tardiness or absences or suspensions or academics, and we allow each school site, their administration and their staff, to pick those students initially who would need that extra attention and that extra help.
So you're in all the schools in the Charlotte-Mecklenburg school system?
I wish we could be in all schools, but due to budgeting and whatnot, we are in a select number of schools. This year we plan to be in 65 schools in CMS.
65 schools?
Yes, 65. We're looking forward to it.
I'm sorry, I don't know how many schools we have in our school system. Do you know right off the top of your head?
Off the top of my head is definitely more than 65.
Yeah, so you have about half?
I would say close to two-thirds, a little over two-thirds.
Two-thirds. And what type of activities do you do with these kids?
It's a large variety of activities that we do. The main thing that we focus on is, fortunately, we have a curriculum that was created by the Urban Institute at UNCC that helps focus on these different areas that students may be having problems with. And so our volunteers have this curriculum. We have a special one for elementary, for middle, and for high school. And the volunteers teach this curriculum on a weekly basis or sometimes on a daily basis to the students to help them improve in these areas. Also, in addition to that, we have what we call a resource guide, and it's a list of speakers ranging from doctors to lawyers to entrepreneurs to college students, and they've agreed with Right Moves for Youth to come out to these sites and speak about their career and to give advice to students upon request. So, for example, if we get you to sign up afterwards,
Of course I will.
You can sign your name on a list and a school will contact you and say, who would like you to come out and speak about your career and how did you end up in your career path, and they will come out. And this also motivates the students to see that everyone didn't start out exactly where they're at today, but they had to work to get there.
That's so true. What are some other things you do with the kids besides the curriculum that you have? I take it this is at the school that you do. Do you do it after school or during the school time?
Well, another unique thing about us is that it varies. The majority of our programs, let's say for high school or after school, they meet as a club. We call them clubs. Elementary, they will pull them out in class towards the end of the day or once a week, and they will bring them together and work on it. And for our middle schools, we have some middle schools that came on board and allowed a course to be set aside and that time be used for specifically Right Moves for You.
Oh, that is good. So you do the stuff in the school. So do you do any activities after school with the kids?
Well, we are an incentive-based program as well. So we provide our students with incentives for doing the right thing. One of those things includes what we call March Madness, and it's based on our pay-to-play theory, which is a student will have to pay to be able to play. And they don't pay financially, but they pay with the good behavior, they pay with the good academics, they pay with putting forth the effort to, in order to get out a good outcome. And we have a March Madness basketball tournament, and we start this in January of each year, and it goes all the way up until March. And we have numerous schools that compete against each other, similar to a regular basketball season. And then we get to March and we go all the way down to a Final Four, just like college basketball.
So what other activities do you have for the kids besides the pay to play?
Well, we have also, we have a Math Madness, which is a math competition that has the format similar to March Madness, and this is very important to us because it prepares our students for end of grade testing, because that's something that we would love to focus on with our students and make sure they improve in that. It also allows our students to learn and have fun at the same time. And a lot of times students just focus on doing academic work during the school hours, and after school hours it's not fun anymore.
So that's true.
Fortunately, we've been able to put that back in there with that design, and that's also a good thing that works. Other programs that we have, we partner with CMPD. We also partner with the Sheriff's Office and CMS. So through CMPD, they provide us with transportation for our different sites. We have police vans.
Oh, that's good.
The students are allowed to go on field trips. They go on field trips ranging from college campuses to entrepreneurship areas and whatnot, and even going to other schools. For example, our middle schoolers may go to high school and meet with some of our Right Moves for You high school students and get tips about what to look forward to on the next step.
Do you do things like go to plays or movies, things like that with the groups?
Absolutely. We've one of the things that we've done in the past are we get tickets to take our students to the Nutcracker during Christmas time. And you would just be surprised at the way the students react to it. They're just blown away by the opportunity.
Do you work with the kids and the youth? Do you do anything with the parents to get them more involved in their child's education?
Absolutely. From site to site, it varies, but we strongly encourage parent involvement. One of the requirements in order for a student to be involved in Right Moves for Youth is that a parent has to sign off on it, and a parent has to get information about Right Moves for Youth, read our packet, read about what we do, and then sign a form that gives them permission to participate. And also the club leaders, who are our on-site volunteers, they take it a step further and they require parental involvement X a number of times throughout a semester in order for the student to remain in good standing with the program.
You mentioned volunteers twice. What does it take to be a volunteer for this organization?
Well, actually, it just takes a individual willing to put forth that extra effort. I think a unique thing about us is that we're able to have a program that can vary on your time schedule. So let's say that you're working from 9 to 5 and you don't have time during the day to get at a school site, we'll find weekend activities that some of our sites may be doing and you can get involved in. If you're only able to volunteer maybe once a month or once or twice a month, we'll set up a situation for you that could cater to that.
And how many volunteers do you think you have right now, roughly?
Well, right now we're gearing up for the next school year. However, last year, the last count we had at the end of the school year was 412 volunteers.
412 volunteers?
412 registered active volunteers.
And so these volunteers, they go on the field trips with the kids also to the plays and that sort of thing. And what are some of your success stories? I know that you're one of their success stories, but what are some of your success stories?
Well, we have numerous. I always tell people all the time, once I tell my story, they're just like, you know, wow, it's good. You're a great success story. So I am, but it's so many more. One of them that the most recent one that I love to talk about is one of our graduates from our East Mecklenburg program as well, Jared Gresham. He graduated from Appalachian State University, and he's currently working at Tuckasegee Elementary as their technology coordinator. And he's volunteered to run a Right Moves for You program at the school as well. So he's actively giving back to the community. Another example is Kenny Moore, who's also a Charlotte native, who played at Butler High School and went to Wake Forest University and currently plays for the Carolina Panthers. He was a Right Moves for You student at Piney Grove Elementary.
Oh, really?
And he still stays in contact with the individuals that work with him at Piney Grove as well. So, and another one is Darren Johnson. He works at Metrolina AIDS Project, and he helps volunteer as far as educating students about safe sex and awareness and taking care of yourself.
I know that you all do a lot of things, and you're partnered with Charlotte Mecklenburg Police Department and the Sheriff's Department, but I know none of the things you do are for free. So how do you raise money in order to do these activities with the kids?
Well, Right Moves for You is a United Way agency. So
it is?
Yeah, so fortunately, 40% of our budget comes from United Way. The rest of it comes from grants and from individual donors and fundraisers as well. Our fundraiser, our biggest one, is the Right Moves for Youth Twilight 5K, which goes on downtown every year. And we're just grateful for the community that comes out and runs it. And fortunately, every year, the number of runners has always increased. So we're just excited about that, and that definitely helps us out and helps us make a difference in the community.
I was at that 5K.
Really?
And oh my God, there were so many people there.
Yes.
I could not believe it. So how much money do you think you all raised from that one event?
Oh, that could be really tough. My position is program director. I'm working with the kids, not the budgeting and finance. But I think it definitely helps. It puts in a good portion.
There were so many people there. Were you there?
Yes, I was.
Did you run it?
Fortunately, I couldn't.
fortunately.
I did a lot of running. I always say I did a lot of running around in the same place, because we were volunteering. We were making sure that there were enough water at the water stops and enough water here, and the runners had everything they needed. So we were just out there working and just happy to see the people that came out. And we had a lot of volunteers as well that came out and helped us too.
What are some other things you do to raise money? Or do you have each school raise so much money too for fundraisers?
Well, what we have been able to do, we provide funding for our school sites. So we don't require them to pay anything to get involved or to raise any money. We have set aside a certain amount of money that we give to each site per semester. And they're able to use that money to go on field trips or to pay for incentives. And we also provide additional set of funding for community service, which is required by our Right Moves for You sites as well. So that's also a big part.
Do you have a lot of police officers that volunteer their own time off work in order to work with your organization?
Absolutely. That's a really good thing for us. Because of our partnership with CMPD, on the middle school and high school level, it's required for the resource officer at the school to be involved with the program. They have to sign off of the program to be at the school. So they're working with it on a daily basis, and a lot of the extracurricular things that go on after school or before school or on the weekends, those same resource officers are out there, whether it be driving students on field trips or taking students to college campuses to get an idea about what they want to do in that next step. So they go above and beyond all the time.
I know that you shared with us some success stories. Can you share with us some funny things that's happened to you since you've worked your way up to where you are right now?
Yeah, well, the funniest thing, I think, is what we were talking about earlier, is my age. When I first started working with Right Moves for Youth, I definitely looked young like I do now. And so the hardest thing would be going into high schools, because now, you know, high school students look so much older than me. And it was a Friday, it was a casual Friday, so I had on jeans and maybe a Right Moves for You t-shirt, and I had my cell phone, And I came in and I sat down on the side of the table waiting for our club leader to come out.
Uh-huh.
And one of the teachers came over and told me to give up my cell phone and told me that, you know, I'm not supposed to be in the halls right now, and asked for hall passes and everything. And I'm like, I'm an adult.
I'm over 21.
Right. So I always joke and say I have to make sure I look like a teacher or something when I go to schools.
So how did the students react to you with you looking so young? Do they react to you as an adult or as one of their peers?
I think it's a combination. I think the good thing about my age is that it hasn't been too long that I've been where they're at, and it's still fresh in my mind about the challenges that they're facing, the decisions they have to make, and what's in store for them. And so when I'm able to share with them my experiences, they sound a lot more recent than what other adults probably could. And so they're able to listen to me a lot more, and they feel comfortable to share challenges that they're facing that they might not want to share to an older adult figure.
Uh-huh. And what are some of these challenges that you've heard so far?
Well, I think some of the things are just social barriers that, you know, it's sometimes very difficult to do the small things that you think every student should be doing. Sometimes a student doesn't want to be that smartest person in the class. They don't want to be the one going to study hall, not because you're in trouble, but because you need that extra help. And they don't want to be the one to join certain clubs that may interest them. I think a lot of our students sometimes frown upon other ones if they're not doing what the mainstream population, the mainstream culture is doing. So I think I give them sometimes that confidence that it's okay to go against the grain, it's okay to stand out, because you are an individual at the end of the day, and you have to blaze your own trail sometimes.
In your experience, have you ran across any major issues that that you've heard from the students about challenges that they're having at home or in school? Yeah. What are some of those?
Well, some of them are what I think a lot of people fail to realize is that a student's production in school is not always solely on the student. There are a lot of other variables going on that
this is true.
That may bother them and that may make things hard at school.
Uh-huh.
It can be a broken household. It could be economic problems, it could be a variety of things. So we have had students that were facing those problems.
Uh-huh.
And what we're fortunately able to do, number one, being a United Way agency, it's a large number of agencies that specialize in things that we're not able to.
Uh-huh.
And so we're able to get those resources, which is in our mission statement. If we can't do it, we're gonna find somebody else that can, or somebody else that can help you do it.
Uh-huh.
And we'll get those resources to help the student get back on track. And those result in long nights, nights of no sleep, because I'm up thinking about what we're gonna do to help this student situation. But one thing that someone told me when I first started working in nonprofit is that if you can help one, then you made a difference.
This is so
true. And so we're just trying to touch one student at a time.
Uh-huh. So any student can be a part of Right Moves for You. Do you try to reach out to students that are from broken homes, or students that they are having trouble with their schoolwork? Do you really focus on them more so than the ones that's living, I don't want to say a normal life, but that don't have the challenges that some of the other students have?
Absolutely. Our requirements, again, we're open to any student, but the students that we're really focusing on that are somewhat the front runners for trying to get into the program initially are the students that are having those economic problems, or having those problems at home with mom and dad, or mom is working and dad is working a numerous job, so it's nobody in there to be there in the after school time. There's no one to kind of give them that push, and so we try to plug them in the program as well.
In your experience, do you see where your organization is making a difference in their lives, the kids' lives?
Absolutely. Fortunately, I've just been with Right Moves as the program director for 2 years. However, growing up, you see a lot of students who were in the program. And one thing that really got me wanting to join the program was I saw the older guys that I looked up to, the older guys doing the right thing, they were in the program. And that was something that I definitely wanted to be a part of.
Do you think that this organization was spread outside of just Charlotte Mecklenburg County?
I think that it definitely has the potential, but at the end of the day, everything comes back to budgeting and being able to financially do that. I think in an ideal world, I would love to see Right Moves for You, but if not Right Moves for You, similar programs active in different school systems and different communities throughout not just North Carolina, but throughout the entire United States.
Throughout the entire United States?
Yes, because personally I think that it's always a need for this type of program in any type of school system or in any region. I think that when we say at-risk youth, we get the initial connotation of a student that's acting out, a student that's crying for attention, a student that's causing problems all the time throughout the school, but any student that steps outside of those doors every morning is at risk. It's so many different variables, there's so many temptations, and there's always someone out there that can relate to that student to get them to make that wrong decision. So, and that's another reason why we definitely open it up to a large variety of students and pretty much any student that would love to be involved.
Do your students do things like cleaning graffiti or anything like that for their community?
Right, absolutely.
Or in the community?
Well, like I said before, one thing we definitely do, we encourage community service, and we require at least one community service project per semester for each site. Some of the things that we've done, our elementary schools, they took their money and they went to a toy store and bought a bunch of bags, a bunch of Get Well cards, a bunch of little toys, and they made Get Well bags and packages for recovering patients at the Levine Children's Museum or hospital. And they were very proud of that, and they kind of did a pen pal kind of thing. They would write the note to the student or the patient and say, get well, and the patient would send the note back saying, thank you for the gift and whatnot. We've had coat drives. We've had some of our high school students pick out elderly or handicapped people in the community who are having problems taking care of simple things around the house or simple things in their yard, and they get involved with that as well as helping out. So it's been really good to see the students get the idea of giving back and want to keep that spirit going beyond high school and continuing on.
With you being a nonprofit, do you go out to other businesses and ask them to give you funding for things that you want to do?
Well, our development director, she definitely works very hard, Shannon Hames, and she goes out when she's able to, and she gets support from the community. Myself, on the other hand, I look at if a lot of times we narrow it down to what someone can give to an organization, and sometimes time is more valuable than what money can be. So I don't hesitate on an opportunity to speak before a business or any group of college students or fraternities or sororities or whatever it may be, to say that just giving a little bit of your time can go a longer way than thinking you're obligated to have to come out of your pocket. So I definitely try to reach out to the community to get more, the most volunteers as possible.
What do you look for in a volunteer?
Well, number one, we look for someone that's willing to make a difference. You have a lot of people out there that want to be involved, that want to make a difference in the community, but don't know exactly where to start.
Right.
And so we try to help them do that. So if someone, for example, wanted to come in and volunteer with Right Moves for You, we set them up with our volunteer coordinator, who is Officer Lisa Spees. CMPD, fortunately, has allowed us to have an officer that works with us in the office. Myself or Officer Speeds will sit down and we'll talk about their work schedule, talk about what their interests are, and then we'll try to run a volunteer program that is parallel to their interests and to their schedule and what they can do.
And do you do a background check or anything like that on your volunteers?
Yes, through CMPD again, we're able to get those background checks for free. So Lisa takes care of that, and once that passed, we put them in there. We do a volunteer orientation, a volunteer training, and it's really more so, it's one of those things you have to get involved in to really get a grasp of what you're doing. You can talk and prepare and read, but you get out there with those students and those children and you start making a difference, and you're going to learn, you're going to win some, you're going to lose some, but
that's true.
But it's all about reaching one child at a time.
Your volunteers, do you go to churches and ask them to help with that? I know that you go to businesses and ask them. Do you go to clubs and organizations to ask them to volunteer too?
Absolutely. Our staff is a very small staff. We have a staff of four. It's our executive director, our development director, myself, and Officer Speed. So when we're out and about, we try to work it as efficient as possible. And so sometimes we do reach out to the faith community as well to get involved. And we do have faith communities involved with volunteering and working with the students as well.
I know that you said that you mostly find your students from those that are in schools. Do you help those that are in foster care or in like a group home setting? Can they be a member of Right Moves for Youth?
Absolutely, because we're school-based programs, regardless if they're a foster student or not, they're still attending a CMS school.
So
we're able to put them in the program, and they're able to benefit from it as well. So we do have various students that are in foster programs or in group homes or in single family homes or have both of their parents. And I think that's the really good thing about the program is that you have this diversity in a program, and so you have students learning about each other, learning about different backgrounds. And sometimes when a student gets a little bit older, they're going to listen to their peers more so than adults.
That's true.
And so when we try to mix it up, we're going to put the student that's doing the right thing, we're going to put the student that's not doing the right thing. They're going to learn from each other, and they're going to start rubbing off on each other to do the right thing and to start taking advantage of opportunities that are put before them in school.
I want to ask you one more question before we leave. I know that you said that you target students in CMS schools. Do you ever go to the private schools to get students? Do you have a program with them?
No, we don't have any programs in private schools. It also comes down to also budgeting, where you're able to be at. And so we look at those schools that are having problems with in the grade test scores or problems with behavior and whatnot, and then we initially put our program in there. But if a school wants to be involved, they're always open to contact us, and we can sit down and try to figure out how we can make that happen.
That's good to know. And do you have a website for Right Moves for Youth?
Yes, it is. It is www.rightmovesforyouth.org.
Well, thank you so much, Otis, for joining us. And if you want some more information about Right Moves for Youth, you can go to my website, too, www.abetteryoushow.com.